Emphysema is a pathological process of the lungs, found in COPD, characterized by the chronic destruction of the alveolar walls and the consequent loss of surface area for hematosis and the less recoil to keep the airways open. This is a term used quite often even in non-medical scenarios when referring to the risks of smoking, for example. Still, despite its widespread employment as a generic descriptor of loss of pulmonary function, it embodies a quite specific and intuitive mechanism. Emphysema is not the disease so much as a pathophysiological mechanism involved in conditions such as chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, COPD. A pathophysiological mechanism marked by the loss of surface area. If you want to be technical, you can use the formal definition of, quote, the abnormal permanent enlargement of air spaces distal to the terminal bronchioles, accompanied by the destruction of alveolar walls. As we all know, the primary function of the lungs is to perform hematosis, or gas exchange, between the blood and the air, chiefly offering an interface for O2 and CO2 molecules to migrate between the blood and the atmosphere. In order for that to happen, these molecules have to diffuse across the wall of the vessels where the blood is, the endothelium, the basement membrane between capillaries and alveoli, and the wall of the alveoli, the type 1 pneumocytes. For physiology standards, this is actually pretty thin, and that's why this crossing is even possible in the amounts necessary. However, as you can see, the distance that needs to be crossed by the gas molecules is not completely negligible, and so it would be overly optimistic to expect all molecules to diffuse virtually immediately. Truth be told, the same surface of capillary alveolar interface can only exchange so many molecules in a given time. That shouldn't be a problem when you have lots of surface available for gas exchange, but you can see why a decrease in the alveolar surface may limit the total possible amount of O2 and CO2 diffusion and lead to hypoxemia. So, how do you lose surface area from our lungs? Well, one form would be to just lose a substantial portion of lung tissue, for example, if you undergo a pneumectomy. However, another way would be if our lungs become, so to speak, less dense. If each cubic centimeter or inch of lung parenchyma now has fewer alveoli and therefore less surface area to exchange gas. Emphysema is marked by the destruction of alveolar walls, thus reducing the exchange surface for hematosis. What we see in imaging studies, such as CT, are large air sacs occupying area from previously healthy lung parenchyma. These large sacs, while full of oxygen, lack the sufficient interface with capillaries to exchange any significant number of molecules. As you can observe with fractals or maps, a single large volume has less surface area than many small volumes occupying its place. Therefore, even if the total lung volume remains or even increases, the blood gas interface is no longer large enough to allow all the necessary molecules to cross. Additionally, there is a second, more indirect mechanism at play. The destruction of the alveolar walls causes loss of surface area and decreases the elastic recoil present in the lung, causing airflow limitation. Think that the alveoli not only are the places of gas exchange, but also provide some sort of scaffolding for the bronchioles they are surrounding. If the alveolus is destroyed, the airway itself becomes more prone to collapse under low pressures, that is, during expiration. That's part of the reason we find air trapping in emphysematose lungs. This damage to alveolar walls is usually due to long-term aggression by airborne irritant from tobacco smoke that causes local inflammation. This leads to secretion of many proteases locally, including elastase. A genetic cause, however, also exists, marked by alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency. Alpha-1 antitrypsin is an enzyme produced by the liver that has amongst its functions, inhibiting elastase in the lungs. Therefore, difficult secretion from the hepatocytes causes both 1. Accumulation in the liver and consequent cirrhosis, and 2. Unopposed action of elastase in the lungs, leading to breakdown of the elastic lamina in the lung. Most cases are indeed related to smoking, though. Emphysema can be classified according to which region of the alveolus is primarily affected. Cigarette smoke usually damages mostly the proximal respiratory bronchioles, leading to what is called centriacinar or centrilobular emphysema, the most common type. This process is found particularly in the upper lung zones, a fact often remembered by students as smoke goes up. If the alveoli are uniformly affected in their entire length, however, we have panacinar emphysema. This is most common in alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency and involves the lower half of the lungs. A point once again, remember as the lung portion closer to the liver, which is also involved. There is also paraseptal emphysema or distal acinar emphysema, which involves, you guess it, the distal acinar. It's so called for being localized around the lung septa and is known largely because of its close proximity to the pleura, the rupture of large air bullet may lead to spontaneous pneumothorax. Emphysema usually present along with chronic bronchitis as COPD. Naturally, since the major complication of this is hypoxemia, low levels of oxygen in the blood, the prevailing symptom will be long-term worsening dyspnea. Other symptoms may also arise associated with the chronic bronchitis component of COPD, such as coughing and excessive mucus production. Nevertheless, that's for another video on COPD. Regarding the process of emphysema, the keynotes are loss of surface area and of elastic recoil. Thank you for watching this video. Please bear in mind that this is meant as a medical review and does not constitute medical advice. If you believe you or someone you know may have emphysema, please seek your physician. If you believe one of our patients may have emphysema, please check the latest guidelines. If you are interested in medical review themes, make sure to check my playlists and previous videos on it. Thank you once more for choosing to spend your time with me, and I hope to see you on the next video.